You ready to fly the Stearman? Let's do a quick walk around before we go. The Boeing PT-17 Stearman was used as a military trainer throughout World War II. After the war, thousands of surplus Stearmans were sold into the civilian market. Many of these were converted for use as crop dusters, a few of which are still operational around the islands. Others are in the hands of aircraft aficionados and airshow performers. The Stearman's great flying qualities, good looks, and open cockpit have made it a true classic. You ready to give it a go? Climb on up. Take a look around, you'll see that the panel is fairly simple. Pilots use a checklist to help them remember all the steps required to safely operate an aircraft. Go ahead and bring up the checklist. You can manually perform the checklist, run the checklist automatically, or skip it completely. Since we don't have a lot of time in this aircraft, I'll run through the checklist with you and help you out with the steps. Here's the engine start checklist. Brakes, apply and hold. Throttle open to 1/2. Mixture to full rich. Okay, ignition on. Battery goes on. Starter on. And we have ignition.
Throttle back to 800 RPM. Oil pressure looks good. Propeller control, high RPM. Alternator and radios on. Brakes released. Notice how hard it is to see over the nose when on the ground? You can look over the side to get a better view. Go ahead and try it. Great. Taxi to the runway. Add a little throttle to get us moving. Go easy on the brakes in a tail dragger, like the Stearman. The tail can come up and flip the plane, so stay aware of that during the takeoff and landing. Hey, we're in the grass. This aircraft can handle it, but try and stay on the taxiway. You're taxiing a little too fast. Stop here and I'll run through the before takeoff checks. Elevator trim set. Mixture is full rich. Prop RPM to full. Altimeter is correct. Oil pressure and engine temp good. Looks good. Taxi onto the runway and I'll walk you through the takeoff. When lined up and ready, slowly add full throttle. tail will rise on its own, and a little up elevator will have us flying at around 60 knots. And we're off. Pitch to climb out at 80 miles per hour, or about 70 knots. We'll climb straight out to 500 feet and then do a little sightseeing. Level out and maintain this altitude. Set the throttle for cruise at 85% or 22 inches on the manifold pressure. I'll pull the propeller back to 1900 RPM. You may need to trim the nose down as our speed increases. Elevator trim sets the aircraft's pitch for a specific airspeed. Trim down or up until the aircraft flies hands off at the desired attitude. A cruise ship coming into port. Let's make our way out there to get a better look. Big ship. Why don't you circle it to get a better view? Yeah, here's where the Stearman really shines. It's a nice, docile airplane with an open cockpit that lets you really enjoy the scenery. Now that we're over water, feel free to put the plane through its paces so you get a good feel for its flight characteristics. Whoa, you got a little close. Hopefully we won't get in trouble for that. When you're ready, start heading back inland to the entrance of the Waikuku River. We'll follow the river to Rainbow Falls. That should set us up nicely for landing. If you enjoy flying the Stearman, you can fly some sightseeing jobs or fly an aerobatic routine at the local air show. There's Coconut Island. What a perfect spot for a picnic. Bridges crossing the river? We'll follow the river to the falls. When flying sightseeing tours, always fly to the right or the left of the landmark so the passengers get a good view. Let's fly to the right of the river so we can circle the falls to the left when we get there. Falls to the left, and then we'll start looking for the airport. We want to start heading back. Rainbow Falls is 80 feet tall and ends in a natural pool surrounded by wild ginger. A good visual for lighting up on runway 03 is Molokai Park, back near the center of town. Turn to a heading of 130 to line up with the park. Straight ahead is Molokai Park. Use the park as a reference to line up with runway 03. Look for the track and several baseball diamonds. Getting a perfect landing in a tail dragger is a little more difficult than in a tricycle gear aircraft. Landing hard on the main gear pushes the tail down. If you're carrying too much airspeed, this results in a bounce, or two, or three. So make sure you're nice and slow with a nose-high attitude before touching down. This is called a three-point landing because all the wheels touch at nearly the same time. Runway 03 to your left. Go ahead and start turning left to light us up for landing. Time for before landing check. Mixture to rich. Prop RPM to full. We're right of center line. For the landing, our approach speed should be about 75 miles per hour or 65 knots. It can be hard to see the runway over the nose on the approach. Some pilots make S-turns to keep the runway in sight, or you can just look over the edge of the cockpit. Nice landing. Turn left at the next taxiway. Taxi back to the hangar. The pilots will make S-turns while they taxi to keep a good view out front. Try to keep it on the tarmac, would you? Go ahead and park it in front of the hangar. Great. Stop here. I'll run through the engine shutdown checklist. Throttle idle. Prop to low RPM. Ignition goes off. As the engine quits, move the throttle to full. Electrics and battery off.
Great flight. If you want to come back and fly some sightseeing flights, check the job board.